சேனல்ல செக் பண்ணிருங்க வரதா.
ஆ சரி சார், சரி. ஓகே சார், லைவ் வந்துருச்சு சார். வெரி பிளசன்ட் குட் மார்னிங் டு ஒன் அண்ட் ஆல். ஆன் பிஹாஃப் ஆஃப் த காலேஜ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட், டீச்சிங், நான் டீச்சிங், சப்போர்டிங் ஸ்டாஃப் அண்ட் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் போஸ்ட் கிராஜுவேட் அண்ட் ரிசர்ச் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் சுவாலஜி ஆஃப் அருள்மிகு பழனி அண்ட் அவர் காலேஜ் ஆஃப் ஆர்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் கல்ச்சர் பழனி, ஐ டேக் இமென்ஸ் பிளஷர் டு எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் எ ஹார்ட்டி வெல்கம் டு ஒன் அண்ட் ஆல் டு திஸ் ஒன் டே நேஷனல் வெபினார் ஆன் ஐடென்டிஃபைங் இன்டெலக்சுவல் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி காம்போனன்ட் அட் த ஏர்லி ஸ்டேஜ் ஆஃப் இனோவேஷன். வி ஆர் டிலைட்டட் டு வெல்கம் அவர் டிஸ்டிங்கிஷ்ட் இன்வைட்டட் ஸ்பீக்கர் டாக்டர் சி ஆர் ரெடி ராபின், ப்ரொஃபஸர் அண்ட் டீன், ஸ்ரீ சாய்ராம் குரூப் ஆஃப் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன்ஸ், சென்னை. Dr. C.R. Reni Robin is a dynamic personality. His area of interest is software engineering, artificial intelligence, knowledge management, software risk management, ontological engineering, semantic web and e-learning, predictive analysis, and cloud computing. Dr. C.R. Reni Robin is a recipient of many awards and honors, to name the few. Award for Research Excellence at Indo-American Educational Summit in the year 2016 by Indus Foundation. Award for Teaching Excellence in Indo-Global Education Summit in the year 2013 by Indus Foundation. Best Citizens Award, India Award in the year 2013 by International Publication House, New Delhi. Young IT Professional Award in 2012 by Computer Society of India for the Region 7. Mentor Award, the Great Mind Challenge in the year 2011 from IBM India. Best Academic Performer Award for the academic year 2011. Best Teacher Award for the academic year 2011-2012, Lifetime Service Award presented by YMCA Madras during the 120th anniversary celebration on 21-12-2018. Dr. C.R. Reni Robin has visited so many foreign countries through his academic achievements. He visited Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Singapore, Malaysia, Wales, and England. He has published 5 books and more than 34 research papers in international peer-reviewed high-impact factor journals. 22 research papers were published in international conferences and 11 research papers were published in national conferences. He is a research supervisor of Anna University, Chennai. Under his able guidance, 6 students were completed their PhD degree and 7 students pursuing their PhD degree. He has conducted more than 30 workshops. He worked as a project head worth of 7 crores sanctioned to Jerusalem Educational Trust by Government of India. He delivered more than 50 invited talks in seminars, webinars, and conferences. He has completed a consultancy project entitled Ontology-Based Enterprise Risk Management for Banking Domain. He has many professional membership: ACM Professional Member, Ambassador for ACM, Indian Society for Technical Education, IACSIT Lifetime Member, Institute of Scholars Professional Member, Engineering Applications of Artificial Intelligence. He is a reviewer of an international journal of Elsevier and international journal of software engineering and knowledge engineering. We welcome you, sir. We are delighted and it's a great pleasure to welcome our respected and beloved principal of Arulmigu Palani and our College of Arts and Culture, Palani, Dr. P. Prabhakar, who is always uncompromised in his commitment, devotion and dedication in his work. We feel lucky to have such a hard up personality to lead this institution and to show right path to us. We welcome you, sir. Special welcome to members of organizing committee, most respected head of the departments, faculty members, students of various departments of our home institution and other institutions throughout India and abroad. Now I am glad to indeed welcome once again all the participants to this national webinar. We sincerely hope this webinar will greatly catalyze such interactions among research scientists, scholars, academicians, students, and pave a way for scientific and stronger India. Thank you, Anadan. Now I would like to invite Dr. C. R. Reni Robin to deliver his keynote address.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving this wonderful 1 minute. Hello. Yes. I'm in a meeting. Can you share my screen, sir?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Please. Please. Hope my audio and visuals are perfect. Shall I?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Perfect, shall I, sir. Go ahead? Shall I? Shall I go ahead? Can I get some response from the participants in YouTube? Can you respond in the live chat? It's my video and audio are perfect. Okay. Okay, I believe that's all perfect. With that assumption, I'm going. Very good morning to all. I thank the organizers from Arulmigu Palani Andavar College of Arts and Science, Palani, for inviting me to talk on identifying intellectual property components at the early stage of innovation. My special thanks to Dr. C. Kantiban, Associate Professor and Head of Department of PG and Research Zoology. So let me start with the importance of intellectual property, right? You know, in recent years, we are talking about intellectual property, right? Startups, innovations. So any institutions, the major pillars are the startups and intellectual property, right? Some of you may not agree with that because we strongly believe on academics and a traditional educational ecosystem. But recently, we started about entrepreneurship, we started about startups, we started about talking about intellectual property, right? Boot camps, innovation, and so on. So, but according to the guidelines of Government of India, especially the Ministry of Education, all the higher education institutions are instructed to adopt this innovation ecosystem inside the campus. So for that reason, you and me are here. And so when you think about, when you study about intellectual property, right, basically we must know what is discovery and what is invention. So the greatest discovery, we normally say that Columbus discovered America, Vasco da Gama discovered India. Once it has already existed, people if go and found something which has been already existing, we normally call it as discovery. But invention is the other way. Thomas Alva Edison invented electric bulb. So the best example we normally give. So one which is newly found out, so we can claim it as an invention. But recent days we are talking more on innovation. We must know what is the difference between invention and innovation. So Thomas Alva Edison have invented electric bulb, that we are not using the same bulb which has been invented by Thomas Alva Edison. But nowadays we are using LED bulb for the energy conservation purpose. So it is coming under innovation. So if you make any change over it, so the going for innovation is the scope for going for innovation is wide. You can make any changes on the existing product, existing process, and you can claim it as an innovation. So I am Dr. C. R. N. A. Robin, working as Dean Innovation for Sairam Group of Institutions. Recently, I have been elevated to the Dean Innovation. It's a new portfolio. Innovation is a new portfolio. I've been promoted to taking care of the innovation activities of the students and faculty members, or to promote innovation activities inside the campus. I was searching to know about what is the exact meaning of innovation. So then I found that innovation is nothing but invention multiplied by commercialization. Invention is nothing but it's a new idea. You have to come up with some new ideas, and commercialization is nothing but you are making money out of it. You're throwing it in the market for the customer need, and customer will come and buy it, so that you're earning money. So if you want to claim your new process or your new product is an innovative product, then you must make sure that these two components are there. The first thing is invention. It must be a new idea. And the second one is commercialization. Okay. And people are here to invest a lot. If you are capable of investing a lot, and if you don't have any innovative idea, then you cannot claim it as an innovation. The same time, if you have new ideas, but you are not making money out of it, don't claim it is an innovation. So innovation, when I say innovation, the money part is there. So commercialization is a part of innovation. So I want to emphasize this point from the beginning of my presentation itself. And the startups, what is the difference between startups and entrepreneurship? So even 5 years, 10 years before, every institution have started the entrepreneurship cell. But recently we have started startups. It's nothing but the beginning stage. When you set up a company, when you set up a new firm, during that period, you may struggle. So those period, maybe 2 years to 3 years of period, we claim it as startup. And over a period of time, you will break all the barriers and you started money. So then you will become an entrepreneur. So that process is called entrepreneurship. So these all for this innovation, for the startup, for the entrepreneurship, what is behind the backbone of all this thing is intellectual property right. If you're not aware of intellectual property right, if you're not aware of the power of intellectual property right, then you cannot succeed in all those things. That is what especially today's program is scheduled by the organizers to get more clarity on intellectual property right, to spread the awareness among the teachers, to spread the awareness among the students, to spread the awareness among the public about intellectual property right. That's what you and me, we are all gathered here. So if you look at the government initiatives, recent government initiatives, one of the best initiatives, National Innovation and Startup Policy 2019, this policy framework, they have constituted a committee. The chairman of the committee is Professor Ashok Jhunjhunwala, professor of Indian Institute of Technology, Madras. You know, Professor Ashok Jhunjhunwala is one of the leading entrepreneurship evangelist, innovation evangelist. He started this innovation ecosystem in IIT Madras long time back. So making, converting the ideas into prototype, converting the ideas into product, and making money out of it, and getting intellectual property rights, patent. So he is doing it for a long time. So Government of India has appointed him as the chairman for National Innovation and Startup Policy. We call it as NISP. The main reason, and the policy has been given to all the higher educational institutions. Suppose if you are representing an education institutions, you'll be well aware of this National Innovation Startup Policy. If you're not been a part of National Innovation Startup Policy, don't delay. Without zero time period, you just go to the website and make yourself as a member of National Innovation Startup and Startup Policy. Here, the Government of India, through the Ministry of Education, is promoting the innovation ecosystem. So we need to transform. This is the right time to transform from our traditional educational system to innovation ecosystem. That part is NISP taking care of. Other initiatives of Government of India, like Institutions Innovation Council, IIC, most of you would have been member. If you are not member, become a member of it. And ARIA, so the performance will be monitored with the help of ARIA. And ICTI 2.0, Kabila, to promote a patent. These are all various initiatives of government. I will give a few more information in the future slides. So to talk about the innovation institutions, innovation council. So any institutions, so who can establish an innovation or institution innovation council in the campuses? So they have given certain norms, having pre-incubation centers or incubation centers or student idea club. If you have in your campus, you can go for and can participate in ARIA ranking, participate in NIRF ranking. These institutions, and definitely you will fit in any one of these categories. And if you have not been a part of IIC, my recommendation is to become a part of IIC. You will get a lot of inputs from Government of India. I will few some more examples in the future slides. And Kabila is another initiative of Government of India, Kalam program for intellectual property literacy and awareness. So this objective of this Kabila is to recognize, facilitate and facilitate the intellectual property right, innovation, and best practices in higher education India, higher education institutions of India. So even the government of India is ready to provide the financial support for your patent filing and patent publication. So kindly go through the website of Kabila and get more information about the Kabila Kalam program for intellectual property literacy and awareness program. And this is what the flow of NISP, IIC and ARIA. So there are three major parts. One is policy formulation, second phase is policy implementation, and the third one is policy impact creation. So where the policy formulation is nothing but National Innovation and Startup Policy 2019. A booklet has been given and been circulated to all the higher education institutions with proper guidelines, with the standard of procedures, SOP. So keeping that as a standard or benchmark, you can establish your own policy statement or policy document for your institutions. And you can actually participate in the government initiatives. Once it is the policy is framed out, you can implement everything in IIC, Institution Innovation Council. And the third is once you have accomplished all those things, you can go for this ranking, atal ranking of institutions on innovation achievements. Whatever you have implemented to promote the innovation ecosystem inside the campus, and you are claiming, you are competing with your other people, and you are getting your credentials in the form of policy impact creation. And I want to tell something about the ICTI 2.0. And ICTI 2.0 is nothing but a portal created by the developed by Government of India to get the innovation activities of the institutions. Who can register? It's a platform is open for everyone from the Indian academic institutions. It may be an educational institution, it may be a medical institution, it may be engineering institution, it may be arts and science institution, it may be a polytechnical college. So it is open for all the academic institutions who has developed the technology, are working on an innovation. It may be in a proof of concept level, it may be in the ideation level. If you are expecting any mentorship, if you are expecting any financial assistant, this portal is highly effective and helpful for you, either ready for commercialization or in a pre-commercialized stage, however, holds commercial value in future. So the registration can be done by any. So as a student, you can have your own login credential and you can submit your innovation. A faculty can do it, staff can, even non-teaching faculty member can submit their innovation in the national portal. And education institution, on behalf of students, faculty and staff, the education institution can have its own login credentials, and the startups created by students, faculty and staff. So we are slowly promoting the faculty members and students, even alumni, to start the or to set up the startup in the education institution, the campus inside, to promote the innovation ecosystem. If you have any startup inside the campus, you can register your startup and upload your innovations, seeking the mentorship or the any assistance you can go for. An institution incubators on behalf of startups created by student faculty. So this portal is mainly dedicated for students, faculty members, and any startup it's set up inside the campus. I have given the website for registration. And this picture I have taken from the website of UCTI. There is a visualization on the sector-wise submission. How many submissions on different sectors, how many ideas, how many innovations, how many product development have been so far submitted in the UCTI. We have some innovations on healthcare and pharma, food processing and nutrition, fashion and textile, electronics and IoT, education, defense and security, conventional energy, consumer goods and retail, clean technology, chemicals, agriculture and allied industries, aerospace, aviation, so water sanitation and waste management. So these are all on various sectors. People have developed their innovations or people have started ideating. They have given their submission in the VIPTI portal. And this visualization is giving a clear picture on the innovation submitted state-wise. If you look at this diagram, see the Tamil Nadu has submitted from Tamil Nadu, there were 6,425 innovations were submitted. And the second place, the Maharashtra is there, and third place, Uttar Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh, then even Karnataka. So it is giving clear picture about the submission of innovation in the Yukti portal. And I have shown you the visualization on sector-wise, I have shown the visualization on the state-wise, and what is expecting in the next. It is nothing but there may be some visualization on institution-wise. So I urge every institution to be part of it. You take the student project, the faculty members, you can sit along with the students and you can see the innovative components. You can help them to reframe the problem statement. And if any product has been developed out of it having high market potential, and if you're struggling to take it into the market, what you can do is you can get the help and assistance of Yukti 2.0. Submit your innovation at the Yukti 2.0 portal, and the Yukti 2.0 officials will review your innovation and they will communicate you in terms of mentorship or in terms of commercialization. So whatever is required for you, the Government of India or Ministry of Education is ready to help you through Yukti 2.0. So don't miss this opportunity. We have seen some of the initiatives of Government of India, but it's the right time to know about the initiatives of Government of Tamil Nadu. So I don't know how many of you heard about the Startup Tamil Nadu. It's an initiative of Government of Tamil Nadu. So these are all the latest announcement in the Startup Tamil Nadu website. It's encouraging the startups, and they are ready to provide seed money worth of 10 lakhs for 20 startups. So this project is a 2 crores project, and they call for registration is going on now. And if you establish or you set up any startup and you are really seeking for seed money to promote your startup, you can apply in this portal. And next one is innovation driven economy. So the enabling innovation driven economy in Tamil Nadu is playing a vital role. And open innovation challenge is open now. Institution can go for apply it. Okay. So we have seen the different initiatives of Government of Tamil Nadu. We have seen the initiatives of Government of India, Government of Tamil Nadu. A lot more thing I can talk more on the Government of initiatives. If you want more about initiatives of the Government of India and other states, there is a common place available, that is mygovernment.com. If you log in on mygovernment.com, you will get a lot of information. Government initiatives and all state government initiatives are there. It is a Section 8 company. And they are promoting all the innovation ecosystem initiatives to the public. So don't miss it. If you spend few minutes of every day to learn something on innovation ecosystem, definitely will get more information out of it. So this is what my recent certificates. I have undergone a course on the patent drafting and filing. It's an ATL program. All of you are aware of ATL program, AICT Training and Learning Academy. I need to thank Government of India and the Ministry of Education for this kind of initiatives. And if you have not registered, be a part of ATL. And without any delay after this presentation, this webinar, go to ATL website and register yourself. There are a lot of courses are available. ATL program courses, 5 days program from Monday to Friday. Previous week, last week, I have attended one program on innovation management from process to product. I have attended. It was very useful. So these are all various avenues provided by the Government of India to equip you. The teachers must grab the opportunity wherever the opportunities are available. Don't miss it and grab this opportunity. So I have completed the innovation ambassador program by the Government of India, Ministry of Education. Last 1 month program I have conducted, and last Saturday only it was ended. And they are calling us innovation ambassador. Once the program is, the course is completed, we will be called as innovation ambassador. The main purpose is we have to promote this innovation ecosystem to other institutions, students and faculty members. Even I'm as an ambassador, I'm sitting in front of you. I'm here in Chennai and you are seeing this program from different parts of country, and even some registration I have understood from the organizer that some participants from outside country, people are seeing it. We are here, I am sitting in front of you as an innovation ambassador to promote the innovation ecosystem. So it's not for getting a certificate sake of certificate. Getting knowledge on innovation ecosystem is the need of the hour for every teacher. As I said, as I mentioned earlier, we are slowly migrating from our traditional educational ecosystem, from traditional ecosystem, education ecosystem, to innovation ecosystem. And need to, if you want to excel in this area, you need to get more insight on innovation ecosystem. If you, a teacher is trained, I strongly believe that you can transform your knowledge to your students. There is no doubt at all. Okay, with this small direction, let us go to the point of discussion. We are here to know about intellectual property right. Okay, what are the properties you are aware of? Any guess? There are different types of properties you might have heard. The movable properties, immovable properties, and the third property, what we are going to see today, is intellectual property. All moving properties are like car and jewels are being considered as movable properties. Immovable properties, can anyone say what is this house? What is this? It's a house. The famous cricketer Sachin Tendulkar house. So this house, land, we consider as properties. These properties are coming under immovable properties. Okay, and the third property, what you are supposed to know, is intellectual property. Gone all the days, the people, wealth of a people will normally judge by the amount of movable property and the immovable property. But now the need has come, the days are coming to determine the wealth of an individual with the help of the intellectual property. Everything is nowadays moving towards intellectual. Okay, even there's a heroism in the literatures. So see, the martial art heroism and intellectual heroism. Martial arts heroism, people believe on their strength, but intellectual heroism is nothing but people will apply their different strategy to win in the war. So the time has come to know more about intellectual property. If you don't be happy with your movable property and immovable properties, you just think about intellectual property. And the great inventions, we normally say that wheel has have given the revolution. It's debatable whether the fire is an invention or discovery, and paper is another invention. And I have to mention this steam engine here, because we are all talking about industry 4.0 now. But what made to the origin of this industry revolution started from the immediately after the invention of steam engine. So it was invented between 1763 and 1775. The Scottish inventor James Watt, where the revolution started in the form of industry 1.0. Now we are in 4.0. We are more talking on the machine learning. Machines are started learning, because we have studied that computers are an idiotic machine. Whatever we program, they respond accordingly. But nowadays, even that machine has started thinking. Machine has started thinking on its own based on a lot of algorithms. I'm basically a professor of computer science. I used to give lecture on machine learning, data science. So machine, even the definition, it has changed. The industry 4.0 has changed the formal definition of computer. Nowadays, you cannot go and say that computers are idiotic machine. The latest innovation in the robotics is Sophia. I don't know how many of you heard of this Sophia robot. Okay, whatever you ask, it's a mission, but whatever you ask, it will respond to you. So that is the power of the industry 4.0 and the algorithm. And even the mission has started thinking on its own. So that's, we call it as the machine learning. So the growth of, if you look at the, it's all the, because of the internet. I have to thank internet for everything and the people have devoted. And when 1977 I was born, there were only 111 hosts on internet throughout the world, and became 230 in 1981, 562 in 1980. Just to look at the growth, even nowadays, everybody we have internet connected, either a mobile phone or the laptop or something like that. Okay, this picture, wherever I go, I normally show this innovation. So this will give you a clear picture about what is innovation. What is innovation? Okay. So you all, I don't know how many of you have seen this kind of grinder. Our grannies used to grind something with the help of this grinder. Then we slightly moved to this type of grinder. Then finally we have moved to this. What is the innovation over there? So people, I will show you a small video where a small innovation, an idea has been shared or the incorporated in the existing grinder. What idea is, so instead of wetting or how to take the flour out of the ground grinder, this is what the innovation, and people have found the solution also. Okay, I'm taking to this video just to have a look on this video. Maybe you may not be able to see it because I have not shared this one. Yeah. I'll share my entire screen so that now you see my screen, am I right? Yes.
கிரைண்டர் பத்தின ரிவ்யூ அண்ட் டெமோ தான் நான் உங்களுக்கு காட்ட போறேங்க. அதாவது கையே வைக்காம எப்படி இந்த மாதிரி அழகா வந்து மாவு எடுக்கலாம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி நம்ம பார்க்கலாம். அம்மா வந்து ரொம்ப நாளா,
so without wetting your hand how you can take the flour, this is what the அப்பதான் இந்த ப்ராடக்ட் பத்தி தெரிய வந்து இது எங்க the specialty of this product, the specialty of this innovation. I can see that
in the shop's details ellame keela description la irukku, adhe mari screen la number scroll a irukku, andha number ku neenga contact panni address details adukapra idha pathina inquiries ellame neenga ketukalaanga. Indha now ipo vaangi irukra indha grinder oda advantages la enna appdin solli paathinga, idhila nama kaiye vekka thevai kedaiyadhu. Adhe maadhiri paathinga easy mechanism, namakku oru half an hour la vandhu maavu ulundhu ella arachi edukudha appdina idhu vandhu 20 minutes la ellame mudinjirudhu. Indha sooda irudhu ellame na ungalku enna appdin solli sonna mari inga vandhu unnala shop ku இப்போ ஓவரால் இந்த கிரைண்டர் வந்து இப்படி தான் இருக்குது. கம்ஃபர்ட் ப்ளஸ்னு முன்னாடி கொடுத்துருப்பாங்க. இதில் இருக்கிற இந்த அட்டாச்மெண்ட்ஸ், இந்த ஐட்டம்ஸ் எல்லாம் என்னென்ன அப்படின்னு சொல்லி பார்க்கலாம். மூணு கல் இருக்கிற மாதிரி கொடுத்துருக்காங்க.
இட்ஸ் ஆல் நார்மல் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் அண்ட் யூ குட் சீ ஹவ் தே ஆர் டேக்கிங் தி ஃப்ளார் வித்தவுட் தி வெட்டிங்.
இப்போ வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வந்து தண்ணி ஊத்தினதுக்கு அப்புறம் நான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் உளுந்து தான் ஆட் பண்றேன். இப்போ பாத்தீங்கன்னா அதுல மூணு கல் இருக்கு. மூணுமே டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஸ்பீட்ல சுத்துறதுனால நமக்கு மாவு வந்து ஈஸியா ஆயிடுது. உளுந்து இப்போ நமக்கு ஒரு 15 நிமிஷம்.
Now it's almost grinded. See how it is, the flour is, they are opening the knobs and automatically the flour is ejecting.
ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா மாவு எவ்வளவு அழகா வெளியில வருது அப்படின்னு சொல்லி பாருங்க. இந்த ஐஸ்கிரீம் ஃபேக்டரிஸ்ல எல்லாம் பாத்தீங்கன்னா இப்படிதான் வந்து ஐஸ்கிரீம் வெளியில வரும். பார்க்கும்போது அப்படிதான் தெரிஞ்சது. உளுந்து வந்து கையே, உளுந்து அரிசி எதுவுமே கையே வைக்க தேவையே கிடையாது உங்களுக்கு.
You need not put your hand inside the grinder. Without wetting your hand, you can get the flour automatically. Everything comes out. So this is what an innovation. So as I mentioned earlier in the beginning, you can make innovation for any product. So what I have, when I have a pen, if you want to make any innovation over this, it's possible. Okay. I will share my PPT now. Kindly confirm. Yeah, my PPT is now shared. Okay, so this is what the innovation, you can incorporate innovation over. Now let's see the formal definition for the intellectual property rights. It's a term referring to a number of distinct types of creation of mind for which property rights are recognized. So intellectual property rights is nothing but a right that is led by a person or by a company to have exclusively rights to use its own plan, ideas, or other intangible assets without the worry of competition, at least for a specific period of time. Specific period of time, it is 20 years of time, or it depends on copyright. We have different patent, we have different. I will tell you the period of the patent or the intellectual property right. So basically, intellectual property rights, the whatever you, your idea, whatever you are proposing, you can protect with the help of the intellectual property right. So it's a licensing. A licensing is a partnership between an intellectual property right owner and another who is authorized to use such rights in exclusive for the an agreement payment. Say, suppose you are an inventor and you want to give this license to somebody who is capable of promoting it and commercialize it, so that through this IPR licensing, you can share it and you will get the royalty of whatever you have. And the importance of intellectual property right, set your business apart from competitors. Now we are living in a competitive world. Whatever we do, we have to show our uniqueness. When you identify uniqueness, it may be in the product, it may be a process. You need to have the intellectual property right so that nobody will copy your product. Even if somebody is copying, you can stop them and you can get the remedial things. And be assigned, gifted, sold, and licensed like any other property. Even if you want to pledge it in a for loan, you can do it. And the intellectual property can be given to the legal heirs, or the if you want to sell it, you can sell it, or you can if you want to gift your intellectual property to your loved one, you can do it. These are all the possible things. So when you look at the different types of intellectual property rights, we have this industrial design, we have trademark, we have trademark secret, we have geographical indication, we have patent, we have copyrights. These are all different types of, we will see one by one. And industrial design, so it's a typical example for industrial design. So if you look at the bottle, Coca-Cola bottle, in 1999, the bottle was like this one. Then they have changed in 1990, 1915, 1916, 1957, and 1986. I think nowadays we are using this kind of bottle. So it is all coming under even the jewelry design is a part of the industrial design, and it's all depends on the products: front view, rear view, left side view, right side view, top view, bottom view. So industrial design. It's a kind of intellectual property. And the next one is a trademark, a distinctive sign or indicators used by an individual organization, a business organization. So if you look at these pictures, even without, by looking this diagram or the trademark symbol, you could recognize the company or the service providers. So Apple, we have Samsung, we have Coca-Cola, we have Google, we have YouTube, we have Yahoo, we have MasterCard, we have so a unique symbol representing a business. Could you please respond, if you know, can you say the name of the company using this trademark love, whether I don't know whether it is enabled. Live chat is not enabled, it seems. So otherwise I would have got the response from the live chat. So it's Alan Sholi, Sarana Bhavan symbol, Apple symbol, and the famous Malabar jewelry. And the duration is trademarks is valid for 10 years for the date of application. And the next intellectual property we are going to see is geographical indication. Geographical indication is a name or sign used on certain products which corresponds to a specific geographical location or region. Can you able to recognize the product with the help of the geographical location? So this is the famous halwa, Tirunelveli halwa, and this is Rajabalayam dog, this is Madurai Malli. These products or these things have got on the based on the regions. When I asked one of the halwa makers, so why Tirunelveli halwa is very tasty. Even if you bring the same ingredients to Chennai and if you make the halwa, it won't come. and he said that the taste is because of the water, Tamrabarni river water. So the water is giving more taste for this. So because it will work out only on that region alone, that region alone. So if you have anything specifically on your region and it is not available in other parts, then you can go for geographical indication. Even we have lost several geographical indications because of the lack of awareness on geographical intellectual property rights. So it is better to go and register your intellectual property in the name of geographical indications if you identified anything with respect to your region. And nationwide, if you look at agriculture, we have Darjeeling tea from West Bengal. Kanchipuram silk is a very famous silk of Tamil Nadu, and the manufacture Mysore sandal soap from Karnataka, and Vinknari Bhujia from Rajasthan. These are all got famous because of the regions. It's all the named because of the region. So it's all coming under geographical indication. And there was a dispute between Bangalore Rasagulla and Odisha Rasagulla. So the it came to court, and the court has given the verdict based on the justification. The court has given the geographical indication to both Rasagulla because of these differences. And they claimed, Bangalore Rasagulla, they claimed that their origin, they have originated, it is originated from 1860s, and Odisha, they were claiming that it is, we are using it from 12th century. Historical background, if you look at the historical background of Bengal Rasagulla and Odisha background, Rasagulla. Bengal Rasagulla was first made by Nobin Chandra Das in Kolkata. Here the Odisha Rasagulla was used as an offering to the temple of Lord Jagannath. And the court has given in geographic indication to both because of some differences in colors. Bengal Rasagulla was white in color, and the Odisha Rasagulla was light brown in color. Texture is spongy, the Bengal Rasagulla, and it is soft. It is soft in Odisha Rasagulla. Taste is sweet in taste. Bengal Rasagulla is very sweet in taste, but Odisha Rasagulla is very soft and not very sweet in taste. Based on these differences, the court has given geographical indication to both Bengal Rasagulla and Odisha Rasagulla. If you look at this picture, there was a contradiction between the famous singer SBB sir and Ilayaraja sir, music director Ilayaraja sir. I don't want to talk more on this. It came because of the copyright. And you would have seen this diagram, Mona Lisa, Leonardo da Vinci, the very famous picture, a painting of 16th century. Even today, we have lot of songs, lot of artistic work based on Mona Lisa. So you can go for copyright for any literary work. If you are writing a book, if you are writing a notes or whatever it may be, you can go for literary, go for copyright. And if you take any film, maybe even if it is a short film, you can go for copyright. If you are writing the drama and you are making people to act, so you can go for dramatic, because people won't copy it. But nowadays everything become digital, so people started copying from one version to another version. So you would have seen it in the YouTube copyright issues. And the music, you can go for copyright, or for any artistic work you can go for. And the sound recording, you can go for the thing. And copyright can be claimed for any painting. Copyright can be claimed for any culture. Copyright can be claimed for any drawing, a diagram, map, chart, plans, engravings. Can go for copyrights. And artistic works like the covers and the diagrams, Coca-Cola bottle diagram, Life of Soap cover, Matchbox cover, cinematography works, we can go for copyright. So what is the author right? So they can reproduce, they can publish it, they can perform, they can communicate to public, they can adopt translation. These are all possible for the copyright owners. And the lifetime is the life plus 60 years. So you can extend it life plus 60 years for literary work, dramatic work. For cinematography and sound recording, it is fixed to 60 years you can apply. And if you want, you can transfer your copyright to somebody by assigning in written contract agreement in writing for publisher, for employee or copyright society. And so how to make a copyright is a common question, because even the computer programs, you can go for copyright in India, computer programs, how we can go. So there is a register of copyrights in the copyright office, register office. So you have to file officially, you have to file an application. I will tell you the content of the application in the next slides. And the registrar of copyrights will go through it. And if there are any dispute, the explanation will be asked by the applicant, from the applicant. And if the registrar is convened, then he will make the entry in the register of copyright. This is a simple procedure. Even the fees is very, very less. So if you have written anything, any book, anything, so don't forget to copy, get the copyright from the copyright office. So you will get the TM60 certificate. So once the application is filed, you will be given 30 days of time for objection, notice or hearing or order. If there is no objection from anybody, the copyrights will be provided for that. If there's a formal letter, governing letter, we have to submit to the Register of Copyrights, Copyright Office, Delhi. So we have to say that in accordance with Section 45 of the Copyright Act 1957, I hereby apply for registration of copyright and request you that entries may be made in the Register of Copyrights, the enclosed statement of particulars sent herewith in triplicate. Let's see the content, what are the items you are supposed to. So you have to give the name and address, nationality of the applicant. So since you are, when you go for application, file an application, you will automatically become the applicant. Your name and your address must be specified in the statement of particulars. And nature of applicant's interest in the copyright of the work, you have to mention class and description of the work, title of the work, language of the work, name, address, and nationality of the author. And if the author is deceased, the date of deceased, then whether the work is published or unpublished. So these are all the information you need to provide. In addition to that, you need to provide the furthermore statements, like is the work to be registered as an original work or translation of the work in the public domain, or a translation of your work in which copyright subsists. So the second information is, if the work is a translation or adoption of your work in which copyright system. These are all the information you are supposed to provide. If you want to know the fee structure of filing a copyright for literary, dramatic and musical or artistic work, 500 rupees, 200 rupees we charge for literary or artistic work, 5,000 rupees for cinematographic film, for sound recording 2,000. So these are the fee structure for copyright. Now let's move to the intellectual, the patent. Patents are legal documents. So patentability will, patent will be given based on the three parameters. One is novelty, intensive, inventive steps, and utility. So patent is exclusive right granted to everyone who invents new or improved product or process by the government. So patent provides protection, but it's applicable for 20 years from the date of filing. Okay, so the criteria is, as I said earlier, there are three criteria. One is novel. Any invention, anything, when you go for patentability, you have to justify the novelty on it. Then what is the inventive steps you have incorporated in that? And what is the industrial application? Who will be your customer? Because innovation, when I say it is a part of commercialization, you have to insist the people, those who are going to get out a benefit out of it. See, advantage, it's similar what we have seen in the intellectual property. You have a lot of properties, and some of the things are not invention. Any process for medical, surgical, it will not coming under the treatment of human beings, not coming under the patent or inventions. The mere discovery of new form of known substance, you cannot claim for a patent. a traditional knowledge. You are taking traditional knowledge and you cannot claim yourself a patent fix. And you must know who is authorized. Sorry, who is authorized to provide a patent? Please have a look on this. So the patent, normally the provider is Indian Patent Office, Ministry of Commerce, Government of India. We have four offices, one at Delhi, one at Mumbai, one at Chennai, and one at Calcutta. So these are all the formal procedure of filing a patent. Initially, you have to file the provisional application. Then you can take 12 months of time to complete your application, formal application. Once it is things, then it will be published and you can see it in the and the pre-apposition. Suppose somebody is it, once it is published, it is available for everyone or available for public. So what you can do is, anybody can see it. And if you see there is a public, if you are seeing that somebody has taken your idea and they have filed and they are going to claim, then what you need to say, you have to give objection to in a specified format. So after getting your the objection, the controller will get explanation from the applicant. Okay. And there will be an examination, whether examination purely based on your novelty, purely based on your industrial application and your inventive steps. And the fees involved for, there are several forms, form 0, form 2, form 3, form 9. Form 18 are there, and the first examination report. So within 48 months, we'll get the first examination report. It's very important. So we have to give proper justification for all the questions to the controller, and if it is satisfied, then the patent will be granted. So all we want is this kind of patent. At the end of the day, you will get a patent certificate like this. People are searching for this. Okay. So where we have to patent searching is an art. Patent searching is an art. These are all some of the free databases where you can go and get your patent, search your patent. Okay. Before going for filing, you need to search whether this idea is existing or not. What is your, so by getting the searching and you will get entire document, and after getting the document, you can compare your document with the your idea, so that you can rewrite your statements, rewrite your entire documents. After that, you can submit. Otherwise, if you are submitting or if you're filing as it is, then over a period of time, it becomes obsolete. So in order to avoid that, you can go for the patent thing. So I have exclusively video on the patent search. Okay, I will share to the organizer in the StreamYard. So hope the organizer will share, you know, in our period of times. Okay. This I am sharing to the organizer. So this video, I have covered the entire process, and you can see the organizers. You can, if possible, you can pass it on the participants. And we have the Indian pattern, Google pattern, advanced pattern search, Indian pattern, US pattern, SpaceNet is European pattern database. And you can, once it is patent is approved, you can claim it for 20 years. 20 years will be calculated from the date of filing your application. And another point is the difference between the research paper and patent publication is when you publish a paper, there is a credential treaty that the first author will get more credit, second author will get less credit, and the third author will get even lesser credit. The normal procedure says that if there are two authors, 50-50 share. If there are three authors, the first 60% will be shared by first two others, remaining 40% it goes to the third other. There's a discrepancy between the credentiality of getting the credentiality. But in patent, there is no upper limit. even if 100 people have filed, all the 100 people will get the same credential too. Okay, so keep it in your mind and try to convert your ideas, the papers into, before publishing it into pattern, you will get more recognition. And the Intellectual Property Office, I am giving the Intellectual Property Office Delhi, Intellectual Property Office Mumbai, Intellectual Property Office Chennai, we have an office at Guindy, Intellectual Property Right to Kolkata. And we have exclusively department in Anna University. The department name is Center for Intellectual Property, and the affiliated institutions can approach the Center for Intellectual Property Right for any kind of filing or submission assistance. They will provide, that they will make your job very, very easy. And this advertisement I have seen that 2 years back, and there's a scheme by the Government of India, Women Scientist Scheme C. Maybe this time also they have given a call for. So here the people, Government of India will train the people, especially from those who are teaching in education institutions. If you want to get more knowledge, or if you want to change your career on intellectual property, right, what you can do is there will be a training, one-year training. The first month, you need to go to Delhi and stay at Delhi, and you will be getting the training. Once the first month training is completed, the remaining 11 months, you will be appointed at any one of the places, either Chennai or Delhi or Kolkata or Mumbai. So where you will undergo your training, remaining 11 months. So 1 year program, it is only for women candidates. The facilities available. Suppose if you are more interested and you want to know more about this, and if you want to change your career towards this, because a lot of opportunities are there. Even the academicians, if you have special stuff on this, it is going to be an added advantage benefit for the educational institutions. Don't miss the opportunity. And this I have taken, a survey I have taken from state-wise filing of patent application by Indian applicants in 2018-19. So it says that the Maharashtra is topping with 4,197. Tamil Nadu is in the second place with 2,382 applications. Karnataka is getting the third place with 2,138. So if you contribute, your states will grow. And this is what the 10 top Indian applicants for pattern from academic institution universities. See, the top, it goes to Indian Institute of Technology, then Chandigarh University. So there are a lot of universities, Indian institutes are available. If you wish that your university name should come here, then you need to work hard and you have to file more patent. So over a period of time, your institution will come in top 10 position. Okay. For innovation, wherever I go, in Sairam Institution, we are promoting and we are supporting sustainable development goals. And there are 17 sustainable development goals recommended by the United Nations for the prosperity and the protection of the universe and prosperity of the people. So it's all about the 17 goals. No poverty is the first goal. Second goal is talking about zero hunger. Third goal is talking about good health and well-being. Fourth goal is talking about quality education. Even how I am communicating, I am sitting at Chennai and I'm interacting with around more than 100 participants. People are coming and going in the virtual platform. So whatever I communicate in person, I'm communicating, it is a quality education we are providing because of the technological development. Then fifth goal is talking about gender equality. Sixth goal is talking about clean water and sanitation. Seventh goal is talking about affordable and clean energy. Eighth goal is talking about decent work and economic growth. Ninth goal is talking about industry innovation and infrastructural, and then reduced inequalities. 11th goal is talking about sustainable cities and communities. Then 12th goal is talking about responsive consumption and production. What is responsive consumption production? How you are utilizing the natural resources. 13th goal is climate action. 14th goal is life below water. 15th goal is life on land. 16th goal is peace, justice, and strong institution. 17th goal is partnerships for the goals. When the organizers invited me, without any hesitation, I said I will come and share my knowledge and intellectual property right. Why? It is because of the partnership. people, you cannot touch you, you cannot do anything on your own. We need to depend on others. We need to have strong partnership. Partnership should start from the faculty members of the same department. Partnership, there must be a partnership between two departments. There must be a partnership between two institutions. There must be a partnership between two states. There must be a partnership between two countries. So it's a partnership. I am representing Sairam Engineering College, and Dr. Kanthiban is representing Arulmigu Palaniandavar College of Arts and Science. It's a partnership. So come forward for the good partnership and sharing knowledge for the betterment of. I won't take much time or much of your time. Let me give one small example for no poverty. How to eradicate no poverty? What is the solution? You would have seen a lot of apps. So the best way you can cook and provide and meet the need of the people. But how many days you will do? But in India, we have one side, we are living in the society where the heterogeneous people are there. One side, we are wasting the food. The other side, people are starving. The technocrat, what you can do is you can establish a platform where you can take the food from it's being wasted and you can supply it where it is highly demanded. So similarly, you can think, bring your ideas to meet all this, because these sustainable development goals have been given by United Kingdom to all nations. India has adopted it and all the state governments. I have a separate talk on video on sustainable development goals, sustainable things. Okay, I will share that video to the organizers. Hope the organizers will share it to the participants in later period of time. I will share it now in StreamYard personal chat. So I request organizers to share these things to the participants. Okay. Next, so my humble request. So I'm closing my presentation. So you're all watching from different areas, different places. So when you do a project, when you go for any ideation, when you think of anything, focus your experimentation on. So avoid processing, gone all the days. So we thought that when the milk packets have been supplied by polythene cows, we thought it's a gift to the mankind. But over a period of time, we have realized that we are doing great mistake. Using polythene bags and plastic bags is going to be a threat for not only for us, the next generation. So do you have any solution for avoid plastics? Do you have any solution for no poverty? Do you have any solution for zero hunger? Do you have any solution for physical health? Do you have any solution for quality education? Do you have any solution for gender equality? Come out with your idea for clean water and sanitation. We are here to take your ideas of affordable and clean energy, decent work and economic, promoting innovation in schools and colleges, how to reduce inequalities, how to contribute smart cities, how to contribute responsible consumption and production. What is my contribution to climate change and global warming? How to live a quality life? How to ensure universal human values? How to develop positive attitude? How to inculcate professional ethics? So these are all the benchmark for innovation. If you innovate something and go for patent, Uber, the world's largest taxi company, wants no vehicle. It's all this idea. Facebook, the world's most popular media owner, creates no content, but we cannot live without Facebook. It is a platform given to everyone, even common man. 20 years back, I cannot imagine if I put something, people will like it. It's a self-motivation factor. When I do something, when I post it in a platform where 100,000 people are looking and giving likes and communicating, connecting, establish network with me, the greatest achievement. People are living self-motivated. Another part, the negative part is always there. I'm not talking about that. As an optimistic person, I'm always thinking about the positive thing and spreading positivity among the people. Alibaba, the most valuable retailer, has no inventory. Airbnb, the world's largest accommodation provider, owns no real estate. And all came out of their idea. All came out of their ideas. Bring your idea. I want to conclude with the mantra of Hackathon, Government of India's initiative. Innovation leads to new creation. New creations lead to bigger action. Bigger action leads to progress nation. So I encourage everyone to give your best to contribute for the nation. This is my contact details. I am Dr. C.R. N.A. Robin, Professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering and Dean Innovation of SIRAM Group of Institutions. This is my email ID, personal email ID and mobile number 9840222340. Innovation ambassador, if you are planning to conduct similar programs on startup entrepreneurships or innovation ecosystem, so kindly you can consider me, you can take up my number, and so I am here to spread the innovation ecosystem among the people of our country. So I take this opportunity to thank the organizers from Arulmigu Palaniandavar College of Arts and Science, Dindigul, especially Dr. Kantiban, Associate Professor Head, PG and Research Department of Zoology, for inviting me and giving a platform to share my knowledge on identifying intellectual property components at the early stage of innovation. Being an innovator, India needs innovation. It's going to be our contribution for the betterment of population. With that, thanking note. So thank you all for patiently listening to my talk. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So any other questions from participants? So participants, ask any other questions. Put in your chat box.
Kandipan sir, this is my
YouTube channel.
You can this information you can give to the participants. There are videos are there. Most of the videos are intellectual property right, innovation related. So I request participants can subscribe my channel and you can use these videos to enhance your knowledge.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much. So does these IRP portals only for Indians? Somebody asked questions.
IRP or IPR portals?
IPR portals.
IPR portals only for Indians. No, I have shown different things. US database are there. European database are there. The video which I have shared, I have given demo for all the, because due to the time restriction, I'm not able to do any demo session. For my previous shared YouTube, around 2 hours program is there. You can see the different searching engines. It's freely available. So some paid versions are there available. People are using for commercial purpose. So for the beginner, if you want to know more information on, you can go these things. Indian Patent Office available, and the European Patent Office database available, US Patent Office. These are all free databases. Anybody can utilize it.
Okay, one more information, sir. Our Palaniandavar Kovil Panchamirtham got a geographical indication, sir.
Superb.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Thank you.
And also, somebody is trying. Yeah.
It's our responsibility to get the geographical indication for our region.
So, what are the benefits in ATAL website for students, sir?
Madam.
ATAL website for students.
Yeah, sir. Yukti 2.0, students can be a member, faculty can be a member, they can submit their innovation, even if it is in the proof of concept level. You can share your ideas and expect their mentorship or any kind of service they will provide. For the student, you will get a lot of other initiatives are there. See the portals like the NPTEL portals and the NEAT is a portal available. So these portals are helping the students to learn a lot, because NEAT portal, all the videos and the contents are developed by the leading industries. So if you go for SPAM and other things, the educationalist academicians videos will be there. But NET, if you go to NET, industrial videos are there, like the MOOC, Coursera's videos are there. So we can, all the students can engage with these activities.
Is the research students can file for patent?
Anybody, so, even a common man, anybody, even a common man can go for filing a patent. It is not restricted to the people. Student can go for, even PG students, UG students. If you have only, you need to have three things, novelty, industrial applications. If three components are patentability, if three components are there, you can go for. What they expect is the novelty and the use, how, who is going to use it.
So in Palani, near a Ayakudi village, sir, Ayakudi village, so they are cultivating the koya. So somebody is trying to get the geographical indications for koya.
Oh, don't allow.
Yeah,
because don't allow others to get it, because so many things have been copied. Even we have lost our turmeric thing.
Yes.
And I don't want, because it's a social platform, I don't want to mention the country's name and all, but we have lost our credentiality. Because before that, somebody have taken the ownership.
Okay, sir. You go for a vote of thanks. good morning to everybody. It is my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks for one day national webinar on identifying intellectual property component at the early stage of innovation. First of all, I would like to thank our college management for giving us an opportunity to organize this event. Then I give my sincere thanks to our principal, Dr. P. Prabhakar sir, for awakening the passion and desire to support us as a ladder to reach the pole of success. Your constant encouragement has helped us in the best way. Thank you, sir. Then I would like to give my hearty vote of thanks to our resource person, Dr. C. R. Reni Robin, Professor and Dean Innovation, Sri Sairam Group of Institution, Chennai. Thank you for his very thought-provoking and interesting address. Dr. C.R. Reni Robin has delivered an excellent presentation about importance of IPR, Government of India initiations, Kabila, Yukti 2.0, Startup Tamil Nadu website and our Atal website, Innovation Ambassador Program and Industrial Designs, Trademarks, Geographical Indications, Copyright, Patent, CIPR, Women Scientist Program Science Scheme in C. So there are a lot of information you shared, sir, for us. Very, very thank you for your wonderful presentation for us. Once again, thank you, Professor. Next, I heartily extend gratitude to the participants of various institutions for this webinar, for their active participation in this event. Finally, I express my gratitude to my staff members and organizing committee members for their cooperation and support making this webinar is a great success. Once again, thank you, Undara. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Can close the program, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.